remember this. I remember this. This is an adventure. This is a memory. Living on the moment. Don't get old, don't judge people. Because you can't be free if you judge people. Love now, create and inspire.
According to the map, we've only gone about 4 inches, Wilson. 4 inches. I know we don't have much time. What are you smiling about, huh? If we're in Dodge City now, that's at least 250 miles till we get close to Colorado Mountains. Before we even begin to cross the mountains into the Continental Divide. We gotta be there by September, Wilson. 60 miles across the Continental Divide. We don't have long, Wilson. We gotta be here by September, Wilson. It's gonna be too cold in October. October's too late. It's the mountains. It's the mountains, Wilson, it's cold. Not like Kansas. I know, and there's bears. And there's no hoops. There's no basketball hoops in the mountains, Wilson. You can't be playing basketball all the time. All right? We gotta run. We can play basketball after Colorado. I don't know if they have basketball in the desert, Wilson. It's gonna be slower. It's gonna take more time to go up. But when we get to the other side, after the Continental Divide, then it's downhill from there, Wilson. It's all downhill. Downhill into Utah. You can't go round the mountains, Wilson. They go all the way north to Canada. They go all the way south to Mexico. You can't go round the mountains. We're going over the mountains. Okay? We've got friends who live in Colorado. We'll just call them and say, all right, come to the rescue. I'm stuck in a blizzard. I don't know if we'll have a phone signal reception in the mountains, Wilson. I know you want to go to the buffet. I wanted to go to the buffet too. Yeah, it's all you can eat, Wilson. That's what buffet means. Buffet is all you can eat. It's the same thing. We'll get carved up and get to Denver. If we don't do it now, we're never gonna do it. To the King's Buffet with Wilson. Rolling, rolling, rolling. Josh sent me $25 and Wilson sent me and Wilson rent. Rent for living in the camera. So thank you so much, Josh. Me and Wilson gonna go get some awesome food. Let's go.
All righty then, I'm at
the buffet with Wilson. What's up, Wilson? We're having a little dinner date, just the two of us. Pretty fun, huh? You happy we came to the buffet?
Good. I'm happy we had an extra rest day. Been reminiscing about,
like, you remember what it was like in England.
Used to always be cloudy. When we started sun gazing, it was difficult to even see the sun. You're saying we gotta go to bed soon. We gotta go to bed, because we gotta get up early, because we gotta run before the sun beat the heat.
You remember in England when we started sun gazing?
We couldn't even see the sun. Meant to be doing sun gazing. We're going out there to look at the sun. We just found out about it. It's like a brand new thing. And it was just cloudy.
You remember that?
It was cloudy, Wilson. Cloud gazing.
This is an adventure. This is the memory leaving the moment.
I've just discovered, well, not just. Last night I was interneting and I discovered something called sun gazing, which I'd never heard of until last night. So today I watched the sunset, but I watched it directly. I looked at the sun, and it's quite profound what you receive looking at this light information. So I don't feel like I know enough about it yet to talk too much about it or teach anyone anything. I've only just discovered it exists. It's like, not even 24 hours have I even known that you can look at the sun. All I ever really knew is, oh, don't look, it's bright, yeah, it could damage your eyes. You can look at it through various different, you know, things, or maybe sunglasses or whatever. But yeah, sunrise, sunset. Anyway, I'm gibbering, but my point is, I am intrigued. I am very, very intrigued in this whole subject of sun gazing. Enlightened, literally, with light. And to become like a light being that feeds off the bigger, higher self, the sun. Good morning, everybody! It's sunrise. This is my first day of sun gazing.
And there's no sun. It's just
clouds. It's actually very cold on the feet. Very cold. Like, that's my main kind of distraction. But I think that's going to be part of it, especially as winter's coming, it's going to be freezing. But I'd kind of like to overcome having cold feet to a certain degree. I don't know how. You know, I don't want to come out here and get frostbite, but I'm certainly not going to do any damage just standing in the dirt here for 5 minutes. You, on the other hand, you are going to get dirty legs. Hey, Trouble! She wanted to come with me. I think I'm just going to stand here and look where the sun generally is and meditate on that, because I can't see it.
Leave.
feet actually are warmed up. As long as I stay still, they're kind of warm with the earth. It's actually walking and moving that makes them stingy and susceptible to coldness. Stingy cold. I feel like I want to stay longer because maybe the cloud will clear. I don't know. We've got an hour of sunrise. I don't know what time it is now. Technically, there's half an hour on the clock. Half an hour of standing, feet training, and hopefully, maybe I get to see some sun. It's very peaceful doing this anyway. Morning. I woke up naturally, no need for an alarm. Quite excited that the clouds are like blowing by. I actually looked out my window first thing, ooh, maybe the sun will poke through and say hello. Ready, steady, go. And the wind that is blowing the clouds is the same wind that is blowing me and making me cold. So, yeah, it was a fun experience. I'm walking back with the shoes off. Getting a little bit muddy. My feet weren't actually cold this time at all. I mean, I didn't notice being cold. More cold as I walk, I noticed that. They're cold during walking. That was awesome. And I do feel very awake and alive and alert. And I don't feel like going back to bed. Morning. Sunrise looks amazing. But I almost slept in because I was tired. And I was like, oh, do I have to get up? And then when I saw it, I thought, yeah, I have to get up. I'm only like 5 minutes late and I shouldn't really be doing too much yet. I'm still a beginner. This is pretty hardcore direct sunshine, so I probably won't be standing here for much more than 5 minutes. The main problem today was the feet. I just couldn't help but think, my feet are cold, and it was difficult to stay out here long, although I did well over 30 minutes. And my eyes feel great. I mean, I'm using a few techniques I've been reading about, where you look around the lens, so as if I'm doing that. You see what I mean? You're going around and back the other way. But not directly at it. I feel awake and energized and alive. Just very cold feet. Oh, I was using the birds as well. That's a new thing. When a bird flies by, it kind of goes, woo, you know, through the shot, through the screen, if you like, through the view. So I pick up on them and I follow them just for a little way, because that's opening my eye up sort of sideways to get some UV rays in. Oh, my icy cold feet. Ah, that feels so much better now they're in shoes. Oh, God. So my main problem with sun gazing seems to be bare feet. It's only going to get colder. I'm going to need some sun gazing socks. That's going to be my challenge for today, is to find some sun gazing socks. It looks amazing out here. I mean, I'm just looking around, just thinking, wow, look at this. There's sparkly dew on the grass. It's a glistening blanket, patchwork blanket of green. It seems that the most simple things in life are becoming alive. I just tried to look at the sun. Alive. Morning. It's amazing, when I first woke up, I forgot to set an alarm, so I woke up at 8:20, and the sun rises at 8 o'clock, and I have an hour, so actually it was perfect timing, and I caught the sun right as it was coming out of the clouds. Can't really look at it now, it's too bright, but I'm keeping my face that way. and the main thing I notice is that when I first get up, especially if I've woken up, you know, sort of late or whatever, I'm like, oh, drag myself out. Oh, I can't even really see any sun. Oh, well, I guess I'll stand here, take my shoes off, you know, to the camera on, whatever. But then by the time I'm done, I only did less than 10 minutes. I don't need to go back to bed. I feel great, I feel fine, I feel hungry, I'm gonna have something to eat, have some breakfast. Get my day going. I have life to live, you know? I mean, it's lovely to stay out here a little bit longer. Just admire the misty bird flying, magical, angelic morning. We've got pretty blue sky above. Again, there's chemtrails right where the sun is. But I'm trying not to let that sort of get to me too much, or I don't want to spend my whole time, you know, all my sun meditation going, oh, chemtrails, oh, there's a chemtrail. It kind of ruins it. But I just don't see them anywhere else. There isn't any in the sky except where the sun is. These are the apples I got from the sheep field. I kind of want to go back because, there's so many good apples, and they're amazing. I mean, they're really nice. Can't have them getting waterlogged. There's a little bug under there. Hey, little buddy. Oh, there's another little bug. Don't get squashed. Little bugs. Little bits of life crawling around. Yeah, they're everywhere. Hey, little bugs. There's just no room in the house. I put as many apples as I could in the house. There's a fucking mountain of apples. And these have to come outside. And I made a big apple smoothie yesterday, and at first I thought, well, I'll need at least 5 apples. So, you know, normally I use a whole bag. But the ones that are bagged are crap, like apples like this big. I mean, they're not even ripe, they're horrible. In fact, I spent £4 on them, and I'm going to throw them away. I'm not even because these are so much better. I'm going to use them. Anyway, it only took three of these beasts, like that, put it in a blender, you can kind of see, and I drank it like that. It was very, very nice, like the super fresh apple juice. Because really apple juice will go brown very quickly in real life, but in the shops they put all kind of preservatives and weird crap in it, so I'm happy to be having real apple juice, apple sauce, apple and apple. Yeah, they're very versatile. They're the base for all of the green juices, really. You know, like apple and celery, apple and spinach, apple and lemon, apple and something green. Ah, this is so cool. Probably not the right word, but so invigorating. The sun's now gone behind some clouds. Keep wanting to look at it, but I know I'm done for the day, and I close my eyes afterwards and let the bright spots go away. So I just wait. Try and get complete darkness. So like that, hands together, and then bang. Now it's totally dark. I just wait until there's no light spot anymore. There's a robin. Hey, Mr. Robin.
Good morning. We watch the sun come up. It's calling.
Tonight, take an exclusive behind-the-scenes look at everyone's favorite TV series.
SebCam.
Yeah!